Hollywood reacts to the Michael Jackson verdict.
Man, I'm glad it's over. That's all I can say. I'm really glad it's over.
He's Michael Jackson. He'll always be Michael Jackson, regardless.
Comedians screening The Aristocrats at the CineVegas 2005 Film Festival in Las Vegas found humor in the proceedings.
I think the most amazing thing is how they found the jury of his peers. I mean, if he's not one of a kind, who is?
I'm just really happy he got off. I don't think he did anything. Let him dance.
Kim Whitley knew how to grab attention at the Perfect Man premiere.
For you, Michael, now I don't want you going around no more kids, no more Chuck E. Cheese's, no playgrounds, nothing, Mike. And I want you to get a black girlfriend with a big booty, real black now.
Will Ferrell has no doubt that Michael will rebound from the scandal.
I'm sure he will. I think we tend to move on quickly.
Michael's one-time confidant and advisor, Stuart Backerman, believes that the entertainer can rise again if he can come to terms with having all aspects of his life laid bare.
Michael's privacy is the most important thing in his life, and his peccadilloes and his interests, those have been let out to the world now, and that'll be very difficult for him to come to grips with.
And with Michael's decisive acquittal, E.T. special legal correspondent Marcia Clark thinks any future accusations of child molestation against the star may fall on deaf ears.
I expect that after the prosecution that was mounted in his case and the effort that was taken, I would be surprised if anybody ever took a run at him again. I think he's just free and clear.
Journalist Maureen Orth has been following the case for more than a decade. Her latest Jackson piece is in Vanity Fair on stands now. She's uncertain if the star can make a career comeback.